guys. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. And today is a very special day because the package from Lazada has finally arrived. In this box lies the Kebixs 3D pen. So without further ado, let's get this unboxed, and also I'll be sharing with you my first impressions of the Kebixs 3D pen. So stick around and keep on watching.
Mode, please wait. PLA mode, please wait.
And that is it for today's unboxing of the Kebixs 3D pen. Let me also share with you a few things that I have listed about the Kebixs 3D pen. Let's start off with the things that I didn't like so much. So it seems like the templates are missing. It may be possible this is because it got lost when it was inspected in customs. But anyways, I could just look for templates over the internet and then print it out. So aside from the templates getting lost, I'm also concerned with the crackling and sizzling sounds whenever the plastic extrudes from the nozzle. I'm not sure if this is normal since this is the first time that I'm using a 3D pen. I'm going to look around and research if this is normal for a 3D pen. Also, one of the cons is that there is no removable part. Unlike other 3D pen, where you can remove the nozzle in case there's a blockage, the Kebixs 3D pen doesn't have removable parts. So if the filament clogs, then it will be very difficult for you to remove it. So let's go to the things that I like. I like how the Kebixs 3D pen sits in my hand very nicely because of its triangular shape. The forward button is placed in a position where it's easy to press while you're working. I also like the easy speed settings where you just have to click and then you can choose from low, medium, or high speeds. Unlike other 3D pens where it has a slider for the speed, you don't have to guess if you're working on low, medium, or high. You just press a button and you will know what speed you're on. It's also nice that you can use the 3D pen with a power bank, aside from being able to plug it in directly to an outlet by using the adapter. The Kebixs pen also has a nice feature when it retracts the filament a little bit whenever you stop working, which saves the filament and also prevents clogging. I was also surprised that they included two color filaments, each one 10 meters in length. This gave me more than enough filaments to make my very first project. The Kebixs 3D pen also features manual and automatic extrusion. You just need to press for manual extrusion and double click on the forward button for automatic extrusion of the filament. I also like the safety features where all buttons are disabled until the pen is ready for use. But the best feature of all, and I also believe that it is the coolest feature of all, is the voice prompt. Instead of looking at the small screen or waiting for a blinking light to stop, you can do something else while you're waiting for the pen to get ready. And then when it's ready, the voice prompt will let you know. Overall, I think the Kebixs 3D printing pen is really cool and it's a real value for money for 1,300 pesos in Lazada. So that's it for today, and also watch out for my upcoming 3D printing pen project. Thank you so much for hanging out with me today, and I'll see you next time.
Thanks for watching, and don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more My Art Life videos. I'll see you again on our next project.